introduction, and when Dr. Mehta said that he is an expert, I would say that he is aggressively modest. And now this is a, before we start to go into the session, in the pre-session conference, I would like to request you to complete a survey. And if you open your booklet, I think those you find the survey, and I will go each and every question so that you can fill out. And those who do not have, can you get some surveys for those who do not have, for example, superintendent sandwich, for example. So you need to get. Those who do not have surveys, please get the surveys. I will go over these. It only takes 5 minutes. And we, all the questions, you know, are on the Likert's 5-point scale. Five signifies strongly agree or definitely yes, and so on. And one is definitely not. Well, if you see the first question, are you aware of the inner self, mind, speech, body, intellect, subconscious, soul, ego, and functioning? So you can mark it from 5 to 1. And then, do you clearly know the purpose of your life? Second question, again, on the 5-point scale. If we have yes or no, that is too extreme. Sometimes, you know, we are in between, you know. I don't know whether I, isn't it? So that's why the Likert scale is useful for doing research. I want to write a research paper at the end of this, and I want to get it published in one of the international journals. And my happiness and fulfillment score, again, is 5 is like 100%, 1 is like 0. And now here the question is about, you know, we, in our lifestyle we have so many problems and we encounter problems with spouse, children and so on, which is quite general. And my score of happiness, happy, harmonious, meaningful living is high means you're very happy, 5. 1 means very low. So my score as husband, definitely if I am husband, I'll give 5. My wife may give me 1. Right? My score as a parent is 5, as a child maybe 1, right? So as a parent slash child, if you are a child, then you rate yourself, if you are a parent, you rate you, whatever the position you are in. My score as a human being, again. And as far as possible, try to be realistic. Don't try to inflate your picture. That you know, though if you are 4, don't say 5 and so on. Just try to be as realistic as possible to give a clear image. And clashes. Obviously, 5 means high. High clashes, you know. I have inner clashes. Sometimes clashes may be inside. Within inside, you know, whether I should go to this movie or that movie, whether I should marry this girl or that girl. Whether I should I should take this course or that course. In the case of students, you know, I go for engineering, I go for medical and so on. So inner clashes and outer clashes also, 5 to 1 score. Then adjust everywhere. Sometimes, you know, people get adjusted to any situation, circumstance. Some people don't get adjusted. I cannot adjust. It's not my cup of tea. Move away. So here also, if I'm difficult to adjust, then score is 5. Then easy to adjust, score is 1. Others at work, are you following me? Are you noting down all this? Okay. And then, adjust everywhere, others at work and with adjusting with the family members and adjusting my own self. Again, there are 3 variables here. And the question number 10 is, are you aware of all the beliefs being harbored and effects thereof? If you are fully aware of the benefits, then it's 5. If you are not aware, then 1. And would you like to change certain beliefs for better? Normally what happens, you know, they try to have a belief and they stick to it. They don't change their philosophy. This is my way of thinking. I don't change it. So this question is affecting that. And is your behavior affected by others' opinions? Sometimes others influence our behavior. I go in one way and we end up in another way. I wanted to be a scientist, you know. I talked to one of the professors there in India, and he said, why don't you take a course in management science? I was originally from science. I was influenced by, you know. And does your vision remain positive under challenging and adverse situations? Sometimes, you know, very rarely people are stoic. They are not influenced by extremes. So what they do, you know, when they have challenging situation, they get depressed. And adverse situation, they get depressed. And if they are very happy, elevated, and so on. No? This will tell you as to what is your the strength, inner strength, to withstand both setbacks and problems. And did you ever think about what is your realm, that is control? That is, you know, what is in your control, what is not in your control. So do you think you are an independent doer? Some people believe, I am doing everything. Everything is in my hands. There is an external force, so on. So we call this, in terms of behavioral science, you know, I'm from management. We call externals and internals. Externals believe that, you know, if I do something, okay, I'm lucky. Some external force is acting upon this. Internals believe that I'm doing everything, I have control, so on. So full control, 5. If you have full control about yourself, score is 5. If not, score is 1. So have you ever contemplated who I am? Whether you could contemplate, whether you really know who you are? It's a very, very tough question, sir. It's very difficult to say 5.
One should know.
Yeah, one should know.
One should try.
One should try to know. Yeah. Yeah. And then 2 key questions. I'm sorry, here there should be 5-point scale. Should be here. It's not in my, in your questionnaire, should be there. Is our spiritual path giving us desired results? If so, then 5, not 1. Do we have clarity about soul, atma, karma, liberation? Again, on 5-point scale. And maybe at the end of the seminar, you can write down your comments, or even now you can write your comments later on, you can collect these. And optional information is name, age. And these are actually control variables we plug in when we do research, you know, whether there is any difference between, you know, responses, respondents by males, or females, or age differences. Only for the name, of course, optional. You can, if you don't want to give, don't give, it doesn't matter. It's all confidential, and we use these as for control variables. And this is the survey you can complete, we appreciate. Those who do not have surveys, you can collect and then complete this. Any questions?
When you add all the choices, right, you have a score, for example, you have 15, 16 questions,
yeah.
You have maximum of, you know, 15 times 5, you have 90, or you have 16, you know? So at the range of 16 to 90, okay, suppose I'm 16, for example, can you tell me how this is, this example we learned today, right? How the help this exam is going to get into the next part, right?
No, it is not, we don't sum up all the questions, no. These are all different variables. We just try to find relationships between these variables and what you have. Whether
all these issues in the seminar, yes.
Yeah.
And also the purpose is, at the end of the seminar,
what did you change? What did you gain?
Hopefully, you know, right. If you were 3, you will move to 4. Right. So at the end of the afternoon, we'll do that again.
At the end of the seminar, again, we do it and then see the difference between the pre-session and post-session, whether does it make any change in your beliefs and your understanding of self and so on. That will, then we do the discriminant analysis, the pre-test and then post-test, you know, results. And then we don't add up all this. We try to find the meaningful relationship between these variables and the holistic sense. I'm developing a model, research model based on this. Any other questions? It's a good question. Any other questions? I think thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to come out with the survey and then to some. Now we're going to start our session number 1. The topic is Integral Living Without Fear by Dr. Sailesh Mehta. I welcome Dr. Sailesh Mehta.